Today, we're evaluating a brand new prototype airfield matting system that is designed to be more logistically friendly and operate for MV-22 in support of the Marine Corps. The Arctic has been working with expeditionary surfacing systems since the 1940s and goes all the way back to pier steel planking. Today, the system that we're working on evaluating is designed to be more friendly for air transport and sea transport, and also be much lighter than a standard AM2 matting that we're currently using in our military inventory. We are partnering with the University of Alabama researchers there in the mechanical engineering department, so both faculty and students, and also they are then partnering with a company called Alfab in Enterprise, Alabama. What's unique about Alfab is they've been building AM2 matting since probably the 1970s, so they are very versed in how to make them. The Marine Corps are the largest users of expeditionary matting systems. They have an entire group of Marines that are expeditionary airfield specialists that go out and build airfields basically anywhere that we want to operate Marine Corps aircraft. So they are really interested in this new system because it will save the amount of material and the amount of time it takes to install aircraft operating surfaces for forward refueling points and also for arming and disarming their aircraft. So these panels were designed to be no more than 50 pounds a piece. The AM2 matting that we're currently using is more like 150 pounds. So these are much, much lighter. The surface area unit weight is only 4 pounds per square foot. AM2 is 6.5. So these are a whole lot lighter and easier to handle. They're also specifically designed to fit into a 20-foot ISO standard container so they can be easily put onto ships and moved around the world, or prototype unique flat racks or frames that the mats pack in very easily, and then they can be either trucked or sling-loaded by helicopters into position. ERDC is an expert in full-scale test section construction, and that's been really our niche area for the federal government since we started this work in the 1940s. So we know how to build controlled test sections to a proper strength, and so that these evaluations are done very controlled conditions, and that the information that we gather from these tests helps us have better designs, and then we can also write criteria and so that we can predict the performance of aircraft on expeditionary airfield surfaces.
We're trying to solve a logistics problem. Some of the places that we're going to be going, we're going to be fighting in the next battle is going to be much, much harder to get to from a logistics standpoint with surface connections. So we're looking for something that kind of fills that gap and is easier to get to the battle space so that we can build an airfield for someone, a VTOL pad, whatever it may be, and support the warfighter faster. Hopefully we can get much more square footage in that than we can AM2. And obviously that means less trucks, that means less boats, that means down the road, which saves the commander, saves him logistics that he can do other missions with, or she can do other missions with.
We get to bring these students and get them involved in a research project that actually has a lot of value to our military members, as well as for humanitarian operations. And what's great is at the university, one of our big deliverables or products is students. What's great is we can get them involved in research from undergrad level, graduate level, and ERDC is a great place for them to go work afterwards. We've been able to send several students here that were part of this program before graduation, and now after graduation, they're still here working and on this program and developing it and making it even better. In order to get from the theoretical aspect to our subscale experiments in the lab of what we've developed in our computer simulations and transition that all the way to large full-scale testing is a really incredible feeling, because you actually get to see tangible things with your hands and see those get trafficked with these simulated aircraft tires. And so that helps you have a better understanding of the boundary conditions you're applying in your computational models to these real applications, these different soil subgrades, dynamic nature of the boundary conditions that you have for surfaces that have some variability in them. And trying to capture that is very difficult in the model, but being able to do that where you have them captured and they're able to withstand these loads and watch them, this metal get fatigued and tested, and then survive these boundary conditions is really exciting, and it gives you a great sense of accomplishment to see this go from initial design to final product.